Hello again. Let us look at the final question in the week 8 tutorial. Suppose the cumulative distribution function is given by this function. It is 0 for x is less than 1. The value is 4 by 10 for 1 is less than or equal to x is less than 2. 4 by 10 again for 2 is less than or equal to x is less than 3. 7 by 10 for 3 is less than or equal to x is less than 10. And it is equal to 1 for x is greater than or equal to 10. They are asking for the PMF, probability mass function. So if you plot the cumulative distribution function, the boundary value is 0, 1, x equals to 1, x equals to 2, x equals to 3, we will be having x equals to 10. These are the boundary conditions. So for x equals to, until x equals to 1, it is 0. At x equals to 1, we will be having 4 by 10. So, let this be 4 by 10, 7 by 10, and here it be 1. So, at x equals to 1, we will be having 4 by 10 value. So, there is a jump there. And until it is equals to 2, we will be having 4 by 10. And from 2 to 3 also you will have the value of 4 by 10. So, and at x equals to 3 you will be having a cumulative probability of 7 by 10. And until it is equals to 10, the value would be 7 by 10. And once it is equals to 10 or greater, then it is equals to 1. So this is the cumulative distributive function plot. For exactly at x equals to 1, we will be having the probability of 4 by 10. And before that it is 0. So for x is less than 1, the probability of x equals to 0. Since until then, until x equals to 1, we don't have any cumulative probability. From and exactly at 1, we'll be having a probability of 4 by cumulative probability of 4 by 10. That means that the probability of x equals to 1 is 4 by 10. And until it is equals to 2 and until it is equals to 3, we don't have any probability there. So the probability of x equals to 2 is 0. And if you look at it from this to here, exactly at x equals to 3, we will have cumulative probability of 7 by 10. That means that probability of x equals to 1 plus probability of x equals to 2 plus probability of x equals to 3 is equals to 7 by 10. For x less than 1, the probability is 0. For x equals to 1, exactly, we will have a probability of 4 by 10, as we have seen here, since there is a sudden spike there. And for x equals 0, we have probability of 0 since there is no spike there. There is no spike in the graph, step function there. And at x equals to 3, we are calculating right now. The p of x equals to 1 plus p of x equals to 2 plus p of x equals to 3 equals 7 by 10. The cumulative probability of all until there it is equal to 7 by 10. So this implies p of x equals to 1 is 4 by 10 plus this value is 0. Plus p of x equals to 3 is equal to 7 by 10 implies p of x equals to 3 is 7 by 10 minus 4 by 10, that is equals to 3 by 10. After this, from 3 to 10 we won't be having any spike, and exactly at 10 we are having a spike and that probability is equals to 1. So p of x equals to 1 plus p of x equals to 2 plus p of x equals to 3 plus p of x equals to 10 is equals to 1. Since the cumulative probability for x is greater than or equal to 10 is equals to 1, you know that this is equals to 4 by 10, this is equals to 0, this is equals to 3 by 10, and this value we don't know, we are yet to find out. And this is equals to 1. This implies P of x equals to 10 is 1 minus 4 by 10 plus 3 by 10, which is nothing but 7 by 10, that would be equals to 3 by 10. So the PMF would be P of x equals to x is equals to 0 for x is less than 0, that is equals to 4 by 10 for x equals to 1, 0 for x equals to 2, 3 by 10 for x equals to 3, and again 3 by 10 for x is equals to 10, and it is equals to 0 for all other values of x. This is the probability mass function of the given cumulative distribution function. You can solve for this in a different way. We already know that this value is equal to 7 by 10 from this. So if you substitute this, this is nothing but 7 by 10 plus P of x equals to 10 is equals to 1 implies P of x equals to 10 is 3 by 10. You can solve it directly there.